everybody. Okay, how about another movie review? I did that review on Firefly and Serenity recently, and when I was doing it, I mentioned another movie that Nathan Fillion was in that had a great gag reel called Slither. So before I got too much past that, I wanted to go ahead and do a review on Slither. So here we go. I know that glare is obnoxious. I apologize. But that's the box art for Slither. This is a movie in the vein of Tremors or Shaun of the Dead. If you're a fan of movies like that, or even better, the old B-movie horror films like The Toxic Avenger, or go even earlier, The Blob, if you like those kinds of movies, you'll probably like this one. The guy who wrote and directed this, James Gunn, is a big fan of all those movies, and Slither is basically an homage to all of them. In fact, they work references to several of those movies throughout this movie. There's one scene where one of the characters has a TV going in the background, and it shows a scene from The Toxic Avenger. There are several references to the movie Tremors. One place where they do rock, paper, scissors to decide who's going to do what. It's really adorable. The comedy, even though it's a horror film, and I guess you could say a science fiction film, it's really a comedy. And the comedy makes it easy to tolerate the horror part of it. I'm not a horror fan. I have never watched a Halloween or Friday the 13th movie. Just not into hack and slash movies. And while this does have a lot of gore, I mean, it's worse than Tremors in that regard. The way people are attacked and taken over, for lack of a better way to put it, can be a bit rough visually. The comedy makes it so worthwhile. The comedy's really good. The movie has four major stars. You've got Nathan Fillion as the lead. He plays Sheriff Bill Pardee. Delightful character. Then you have Elizabeth Banks. She plays Starla Grant. She's a school teacher, and she and Bill have been friends since they were kids. And Bill's been sweet on her ever since then. There's a joke at one point in the movie about how he's been carrying a torch for her. But she's married to Michael Rooker's character, Grant Grant. Yes, that's the same first name as last. It's a running joke in the movie. He's basically the rich guy in town. This is a very small town. It's a little rural hunting town. And you never really find out what Grant Grant does for a living, but he lives in a really nice house, and everybody knows he's got lots of money. He drives a Cadillac, you know, he's well off. And then you've got the mayor, played by Greg Henry. And he's an interesting character, too. The plot of the movie, deer season, which is a big deal in this little hunting town, is just about to begin. And an alien creature lands on the planet in this little town and manages to infect Grant Grant's character. And basically it takes him over, and over the course of the movie transforms the human Grant Grant into this very bizarre looking creature. And it spreads. The way it spreads, the alien has this way of impregnating other creatures on the planet, and when it's a very short gestation age, basically, and when they give birth, it's more of a case of an explosion, and these, they call them worms, these very large red slug-like things come out, and then those spread out, and they infect people by going into their mouths and working their way to where they can take over the body, the human, take control of this human, and then cause them to kind of turn into zombies, for lack of a better word. They basically become ravenous for human flesh. So some people end up getting taken over, some people end up getting eaten, and some people end up getting impregnated in this little town. The gore is rougher than it is in Tremors. And the language is rougher than it is in Tremors. I never use curse words on my channel. If you ever met me in private, don't think that I'm like some really uptight person who never cusses. I do. I just don't consider that it belongs on my YouTube channel. So with that in mind, I feel the need to warn you that the language is a bit rough in this movie. In fact, if you watch it all the way to the end, the closing credits, there's a song that plays over it called Baby I Love You by the Yahoos. It's a hilarious song. It's absolutely hilarious. Thankfully, the title of the song is just that, Baby I Love You, because the rest of the refrain where that title is used in the song includes a curse word that I can't use on my channel. It's Baby I Love You, but leave me the blank alone, okay? It's just bizarre, but it's such a popular tune in this house that Paul, aka Noferblatz, actually has it on his MP3 player. It's really a funny little song. The words are just hilarious. There's another tune in the movie that plays during a bar scene. This is the kickoff of deer season in this town, and they have a big celebration for the kickoff of deer season, and a tune that plays during that is called Gonna Shine Up My Boots. That's by Corb Lund. I actually don't know who that person is or that group is, but I know it from the movie. It's a really cute, because this is set in a hunting tent, it's a, you know, country song, and the movie cuts between scenes in the bar where there are people doing line dancing to that song as part of the celebration, to a scene where our newly infected Grant character, the alien in him, is impregnating another character, not his wife, she survives, but impregnating another character and turning her into a giant womb, basically. So it's just funny. The visuals are funny when they're not being gory. You have to watch the movie. You just have to watch the movie. If you do, I highly recommend that you actually rent the DVD or buy the DVD. You want to actually, or Blu-ray, of course, because of the special features. This is one of those movies that has a lot of special features. In fact, one of the special features is how they make all the blood, because they use a lot of it in this movie. But there's a gag reel that is absolutely hilarious. You have to watch the gag reel. Every time we watch this movie, we always watch the gag reel again, and the other special feature called Who is Bill Pardee, which is Nathan Fillion's character, and it's hilarious. They give Nathan Fillion such a hard time on that one. Here's a little aside, by the little piece of trivia. Apparently Nathan Fillion was the last person they cast for this movie, and he wasn't cast until a week before shooting started. So that didn't give him a whole lot of run-up to learn his lines, but around here we love Slither. It is hilarious. It's scary. A lot of those, you know, poof, things that make you jump. A lot of startle scenes. But the comedy more than compensates for the scare and the gore factor so that I don't mind watching it. Anyways, here we go. Slither. Check it out. That's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.